tutorials. Today I gonna demonstrate process steps widget for you. Let's see some demos. For first of all, these are the layouts which we can make. Look at the layouts. This is the vertical demo. This is the horizontal. You can see the different layouts. Now this is the demo which is connected with the process and a carousel anything. You can see the example over here, and there are other examples. You can check out in our demo page. Now let's jump into the Elementor backend to look into all the options. If you click on that, you will see the widget process and steps. You can find out that by searching process / steps. You can use this widget. Now in this widget you have option to choose, do you want that horizontal or the vertical. So you can select that from here. After that you have the option to enable display counter. That means if you turn it off, the step 1, 2, 3 or whatever you want to put there, you can change it. Now you have option to put a numbers or a custom text. If you select upper alpha, you will see the text over there. Like if you can put normal numbers, it will automatically change the numbers. And if you want a custom text, you can put that using this option. After that, you have option for the spatial background. The spatial background is the layout like this in a layout 6. If you turn it on, the background will be based on this kind of gradient circles. Now you also have an option for the responsive. In the responsive, if you want this structure to be normal, then you need to enable this option. Once you enable this option, you also have option for the alignments, the content alignments and the default active. This default active is the different thing. Now if you want to show this, same is it in the mobile, you just need to disable it. Normally in a horizontal layout you need to turn this option on. So in a mobile device, let me show you. See, this is the example. Now let's make it center and enabled. So you will see the different layout like this. If you disable this, you will see layout as it is like this. This is the vertical and it's connected as well. But if you don't want this kind of layout, you just need to turn it on. So let's get back to the normal version of the desktop. Now if you see in the desktop, there is another option for the default active. This default active option is available only when you will connect it, this process widget, with the carousel anything connection. If you turn it on and you will put the carousel ID over here, you need to put the same carousel ID in the carousel anything connection. Let me show you that example as well. In a layout tool, we have connected that with the carousel anything. As you can see, if you hover on the second, the layout carousel will change. Hover on third. So let's see. In the process widget, we have put create team connection ID, and in the carousel anything again we have put the same ID over here. So both of these are connected now, and then you can make it work like this. Now let's get back to the normal option. Now in a process step, there is a repeater in which you can add multiple process. First of all, you need to add a title. Then you can add a description over here. After that, you have option for icon, where you can select icon, image or the text or the none. After that, you have option to choose a font style, font family. And in a font family, you have an icon library. After that, you can select the link for that process. you have option for the normal background option and the hover background options. And if you have selected a display counter as a text, you have option to write down the text over here. Same for the second, and you can add more as well. Now, if you have disabled anything carousel connection, you don't have any other options. After the content tab, you need to go to the style tab. In the style tab, first of all, there is a title style where you will get typography options. In a typography options, you will get a font family option, font size, weight, transform, style, decoration, line height, and letter spacing. Three of them are responsive options, so you can change that in a small screen. And you have option for the text color for a normal and for the hover condition. Now, in a description style, you again have a typography and cosmetic options. In icon image style, you have option to increase the icon size or decrease it. You will have options for the icon color or for a normal and hover condition. You will have an image option if you have selected the image. You also have a border radius option over here. If you have selected text, you will have an option for the typography and their color for a normal and hover condition. You will also have a background size option, minimum height of the content. This function you can use if you have a different height for each section, so you can adjust this for that purpose only. Then you have option for the background type. In that you can select a normal color, image, or the gradient. Then you have option for the border types, their width, their color, and border radius. You also have option for a normal and hover condition for a box shadow, transform CSS, and overlay color. Then there is a separator line style in which you have cosmetic options and a separator style with the options of border. There is a one unique option which is called a custom. In a custom, you can select a separator image. For example, let's select this image, and once you select that, you will see that image will be as a separator. But if your image is big or very small, you need to adjust the offset as well. And this image will not work in a mobile devices because of the layout issues. Now you can adjust the border radius as well if you have selected the normal border. Right. After that, you have option for the display counter style, where you can adjust the padding, you can adjust the left and top offset, you can see it here. You can adjust their typography, their cosmetic options like color, background color for the normal and for the hover state. Keep in mind, if you connect these with the carousel anything, all the hover states will be worked as an active state. After that, you have option for the content background style, where you can adjust the padding, you can adjust the margin, then the background and border and box shadow for normal and the hover state. Then you have option for the on-scroll view animation. We have made separate video for on-scroll view animation. You can check it out on our channel. So these are the options are available in a process step widget. You can check it out. You can import all of these styles from Plus Design as well. Thanks for watching, and keep crafting amazing websites. See you in the next video.